my channel. If you are brand new, be sure to hit that subscribe button down below and become a member of the Sky Squad. If you are already subscribed, be sure to turn on those notifications. Glaring. I'm getting glared. By clicking that little bell right next to the subscribe button, looks something like this. After you turned on notifications, comment done down below and I'll try to like or respond to your comment. So as you can see by the title, we are going to be making the world's most beautiful fidget spinner. Oh my god, I'm so ready for this. Give this video a big thumbs up if you are ready for it too. I just might have spit a little bit because I'm just so excited. So the main ingredient we are going to be using today is called bismuth. Bismuth is actually the 83rd element on the periodic table. And it looks like this when it's not processed in its natural form. This is called a bismuth ingot. I don't know anything about like rocks and metals, guys. Ingot chunk. It's 99.99% pure. And when you're working with bismuth, you wanna use 99.99% pure. You want it to be extra pure. So believe it or not, when your belly hurts and you drink Pepto-Bismol, you're actually drinking a lot of bismuth. It's kind of weird, right? So Jay just informed me of something new. The shorter name for bismuth is Bismol. That's why it's Pepto-Bismol. Like, we drink this metal. So weird. Anyways, if you melt down this metal, it actually creates these beautiful crystals. These are so pretty. I love them so much. Cue the zoom up. So to make our mold, I am using Easy Mold silicone putty. This is what it looks like. And you want to get equal parts of each of the putty. If I can open it. Okay, so I'm just going to mix that together. And you want to be quick with this. I learned by past experiences that this hardens really quick. Okay, so now I'm going to press my fidget in there. And this should start hardening up very soon. So, while that is hardening up, we are going to get our bismuth and we're about to cook it up. Stop! Today's shoutouts go to Ellie on Instagram and Amanda on Twitter. If you want a shout out in my next video, be sure to follow me on Instagram and retweet my last tweet on Twitter.
Okay guys, well I'm really hoping that this is not going to melt the mold. The boiling temperature of this is 520 degrees, I believe, and this can only withstand 400 degrees. All right, so what we're gonna do is let this cool down, and when it's close to cooling down, we are going to break the top off and reveal the bismuth crystals inside.
This looks so cool.
Our first one, we weren't thinking, we were too excited, and we didn't put the freaking middle part in, so we're gonna do that now. We're gonna go melt some more.
Look at the triangles in this.
Oh my god, that's a crystal forming, right? Those are crystals!
No way, are they?
Unfortunately, I wasn't skilled enough to make my own bismuth crystals. Maybe I'll try in a future video if you guys want. Let me know in the comments down below. Anyways, I ended up buying these bismuth crystals from my local crystal and mineral shop. And I'm just using hot glue and I'm just gluing them in. So while I was making the spinners, in my mind, I wanted the crystals to grow naturally. But unfortunately, the bearing of the fidget spinner is fairly thin, so the mold had to be super thin. If I made like a thick, deep spinner, I feel like I would have got better results with the crystals. Also, a cool thing to note, bismuth oxidizes with the air and changes colors. So it can change purple, blue, orange, like a nice beautiful emerald green. It all depends on the cooling temperature of the room, how slow it cools. Those are all factors in the colors that your crystal ends up becoming. Super cool.
That this is one of the most beautiful fidget spinners I've ever seen in my life, let alone create. And this one is super cool as well. The colors are just awesome. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.